Welcome back to the Kohl Center. Minnesota visiting number 22, Wisconsin. With the number 2 seed on the line to the Big Ten tournament, the winner will take that number 2 seed. We'll get into the scenarios for what happens for the loser in just a little bit. Still plenty to be determined in the Big Ten Conference on this final day of the regular season as we sit just 1 week away from the lovely day that is Selection Sunday. It is peering in the background and getting closer and closer to the forefront as we move on in this month of March. Let's meet the starting lineups. Let's feed you into PA announcer Mike Mankey.
Starting at guard, a 6'4" senior from Waukegan, Illinois, Zero, Akeem Springs. At guard, a 6'2" junior from Decatur, Georgia, number 2, Nate Mason. At center, a 6'10" junior from Edina, Minnesota, number 22, Reggie Lynch. At forward, a 6'6" sophomore from San Antonio, Texas, number 3, Jordan Murphy. And at guard, a 6'8" freshman from Hopkins, Minnesota, number 5, Amir Coffey. The head coach from Minnesota is Richard Pitino.
Speaking of the lineups, Buffalo Wild Wings starters, there they are. And the man you just heard, Jordan Murphy, a moment ago, he's been the key cog in the wheel. Almost 18 points and 14 rebounds a game over the last 7. Let's feed you back into PA announcer Mike Mankey for the Badgers.
Starting at guard, a 6'3" senior from La Crosse, number 24, Brunson Koenig. Starting at guard, a 6'3" senior from Germantown, number 3, Zach Showalter. Starting at forward, a 6'10" sophomore from Milan, Illinois, number 22, Ethan Happ. At forward, a 6'8" senior from Bowling Green, Ohio, number 30, Vito Brown. And at forward, a 6'8" senior from Toledo, Ohio, number 10, Nigel Hayes. And the head coach for your Wisconsin Badgers is Greg Gard.
Yes, 4 seniors in that starting lineup. And it's only fitting, I guess, Mr. Crispin, that we give them the Quicken Loans amazing performance, because that senior class has been amazing.
Well, and it's not, obviously not just what they've done this season or last season. It's what they've been a part of. And you look at this 2 Final Fours, 3 Sweet 16s, 11 national tournament, or not national, excuse me, NCAA tournament wins. That's all great. But what impresses me the most is that they've continued the streak, and they have an opportunity to really continue it and solidify things tonight. 17th straight year in a row with this Wisconsin Badgers team has finished within the top 4 of conference. That is amazing to me. And to be a part of that at any level is just incredible.
Yeah, it is really an unbelievable streak, an unprecedented streak. 17th year with a winning Big Ten record for the Wisconsin Badgers. That's the longest ever in Big Ten play. Only Kansas has a longer streak in all of college basketball.
But here's what's impressive about it. Let's be honest with what we're really looking at right now. This is not a Wisconsin team that wins with All-Americans, one-and-dones, or guys that are going to have long NBA careers. They've done it by winning with less. It means less talent, and that's not a knock on these guys, but they haven't gone out and gotten constant McDonald's All-Americans that you're going to see as first-round draft picks. They've done it with guys that really, this might be the last time they ever play basketball, and they've won at a high level. So you've got to credit Greg Gard, Bo Ryan, everybody that's been a part of this system.
And again, the winner clinches the 2 seed in the Big Ten tournament. If Minnesota loses, they will be the 4 seed. Those are their only 2 opportunities. as we are underway at the Kohl Center. Wisconsin, meanwhile, if they lose and Purdue wins, they're the 4 seed. If Northwestern beats Purdue and Wisconsin loses, they drop all the way to the 5 seed.
Yeah, I'm glad we're finally at Sunday, last Sunday of regular season play, because I can actually follow what happens if this happens or all these hypotheticals.
Offensive rebound and a kick out. Zach Showalter.
Second chance opportunities are huge, especially when it leads to a made jump shot. This is a Wisconsin team that struggled to shoot the basketball. And as we always say, sometimes it's good just to see it go through the basket.
Last 10 games, just 28% from long range for the Badgers, so that's a good start. Now Minnesota on that 8-game win streak, hottest team in the conference, and that's maybe the hottest player in the conference missing in Murphy. Lynch follows it up. Had it knocked loose, got it back. Offensive foul.
I know Richard Pitino's not happy with Reggie Lynch, not because he fouled, but because he didn't pass the ball out. You're in a position. You got Nate Mason. There he is, bottom of your screen, bottom left of your screen, screening. He's doing jumping jacks. Give him the ball. And Reggie Lynch, who has foul trouble issues, picks up a first cheap one.
He's fouled out of 8 games. He's had 4 fouls in 7 more games.
Yeah, that's a problem.
So that's an early foul and a bad sign for Minnesota.
Oh, if I'm Nigel Hayes, I'm going right at him.
Instead, he says, hey, I'll just pull it from 18.
It's going to be interesting to follow this game, how Wisconsin plays. Do they play with urgency on the offensive end? They always play with urgency defensively. Do they play with urgency? Do they shoot the ball with confidence? Because I think if you shoot the ball with confidence in the game, throughout your scheme, throughout your offense, you shoot foul shots better, too.
Wisconsin certainly coming out with a sense of urgency here so far in this one. The ball will stay with Minnesota, however.
You hope so, because the entire nation's looking at this Wisconsin team saying, I don't know. Even when they were 7th in the country, there were a lot of people saying, I don't know. I'd be happy to play Wisconsin in the NCAA tournament. So I think they've got something to prove, especially against a very good, probably one of the hottest teams in the conference. In Minnesota.
Catch and shoot for Nate Mason, the junior from Decatur, Georgia. Maybe that will help the Golden Gophers settle in. Mason, last 10 games, averaging 19 a contest. And he gets the first two for Richard Pitino's club.
Yeah, you got Reggie Lynch right now and Ethan Happ. I would throw the ball inside, force them to double.
First time these two teams met, they opted to not double half. That was a game that Wisconsin won in overtime in Minneapolis as Nigel Hayes gets fouled.
Nigel Hayes, I know he made that first jump shot, but you still have to continue to gap if you're going to cover him. He does a great job up faking, ball faking. I think he's so similar to Paul Pierce. No, I'm not saying he is Paul Pierce, but the way he uses up fakes, ball fakes, head fakes, shoulder fake, whatever else he can fake, he does it really well.
And I know Wisconsin fans are tired of hearing it, but this is the area they have struggled in, especially Hayes and Happ at the foul line. And he misses the first.
And you might not hear it on TV, but the groans that I can hear behind us is kind of like, oh, that doesn't help, fans. That doesn't help at all. It makes it worse.
See if he can settle in and knock down number two, and he does all day.
There was a time, last time I was here, Ethan Happ took a jump shot from about 16 feet. And the entire crowd just gasped. And he made the shot. They went crazy. You would have thought a walk-on that never plays went out and knocked it down. But it was Ethan Happ, one of the best players in the country.
Murphy, emphatic finish with two hands. What about the stretch Jordan Murphy's had? Last 7 games, 17.6 points, 13.6 rebounds a game.
Yeah, I mean, over the last 8 games that they've won, 15.5 points and 13 rebounds. I would say he's a key reason why they're winning basketball games, because he was not existent before that.
Well, yeah, the 8 before that, 6 points a game for him was it. I mean, it's been a total 180. Stop and pop for Mason. Tapped out, trying to save it, Koenig, but he saved it to Minnesota. Mason had an opening. Good defensive recovery by Bronson Koenig, knocking it out of bounds.
Well, if it's not for the good hands, that's going to be a layup for Nate Mason. And Nate Mason's another guy who has gotten himself into the conversation for first team all Big Ten, and I'm sure he's going to get a lot of votes.
Leads him in points, assists, and steals, does Mason. Here he goes again. A little strong. Lynch had it jarred loose. Wisconsin by two in the early going. Underneath, here's Hap. Caught up, finds Hayes. Hayes kicks out the three, is short by Bronson Koenig. Here comes the freshman sensation, Amir Coffey. No. Second time, yes, and a foul.
Amir Coffey's going down the floor, and I was about to throw a bet your way. I was going to say, put 50 on the fact that Showalter's going to try to take a charge. That's what he does. He does it so well, not afraid to put his face in front of an elbow. But Amir Coffey, he's really tough to stop, does a good job controlling his body and not picking up the offensive foul. Instead, getting an at-one.
Amir Coffey, 31.
Minnesota, Mr. Basketball last year. Big-time recruit for Richard Pitino, but he can't complete the three-point play. We're tied at six.
Yeah, it's important. You got to recruit your backyard, especially when you have that type of caliber of player. He goes elsewhere. It does change the perception of the program, at least locally.
And these are two schools that go after a lot of the same recruits up in this area. Nice feed and an easy lay-in for Hayes.
Ethan Happ doing a good job, keeping his eyes up, finding the open man, and Nigel Hayes moving without the basketball. So he hasn't done so well as of late.
Also two programs, though, to that point about sharing recruits, that there's not really a whole lot of love lost between these two teams. We'll talk more about that when we return. Two-point game, 15-52 first half. Basketball on BTN is brought to you in part by State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800-STATE-FARM. Early going in Madison, 8-6, Wisconsin over Minnesota. You know, we talked a lot about the free throw shooting, but before the game, who are the two guys? This is well before the game after shooter on. Who are the two guys out there putting them up?
Look, let me just put this out there. These guys are trying. You think as if they just want to go out there and miss foul shots? They put more effort into the game of basketball than you think about basketball. And they come out here, they put the work in. It's just a mental thing right now. And I really do. You feel for them and you root for them to make foul shots, because once they get past that mental block, this team will start to thrive.
They were just 5 of 14 from the line of that heartbreaking loss the other day here to Iowa. Happ was 1 of 7. And Greg Gard said afterwards, I hate to say it, and I know I sound like a broken record, but you hit a few of those and we win that game. Crowd groaning over a foul inside that'll put Minnesota at the line.
You see Jordan Murphy going to the free throw line. He's a guy, I don't want to say he was non-existent, but he was pretty much non-existent for the first half of this season. Seems as if a switch just got flipped, and he started to be more aggressive, more assertive, trying to make things happen on the offensive end, and he also picked up his activity defensively. Getting tons of rebounds, cleans everything up. It's a great combination. You got Reggie Lynch blocking shots, Jordan Murphy cleaning up the glass. You have good rebounding guards as well.
Both of them go down for Jordan Murphy. Yeah, it's been quite a streak. I mean, you look at last year, Minnesota, 8-23. Now they're 23-7 this season. Best turnaround in Division I basketball by a long shot. A pass wide to Nigel Hayes.
Well, that's why Richard Pitino's in the conversation as Big Ten Coach of the Year. Understandably so. And he understood that this was going to be his team. He got Eric Curry. He really understood what he had coming back. And he obviously loved building on Nate Mason, Jordan Murphy. He knew what he had in Reggie Lynch. Keith Springs, I mean, he had all the pieces, and he felt as if this was his team. You get Amir Coffey, and you get even more confidence.
I asked him about Reggie Lynch, because you said he knew what he had in him. He said, I did, because he sat out last year, and my guys had to go against him every day. I could not wait to get him eligible. And then Akeem Springs, right, the grad transfer, is averaging 10 points a game. This time, it's Amir Coffey. He's another new piece, the freshman with a smooth left hand.
You see the length and the ability to take one dribble from 25 feet out and get all the way to the basket. With good spacing, adequate shooters around the perimeter, particularly in Akeem Springs, he's going to be able to get that when he wants.
And Minnesota, they are tired of hearing about a six-game losing streak to these guys. That's a foul on Wisconsin. Well, there are your Coach of the Year candidates.
Not in any order. I mean, look, I got to vote. I won't tell you who I voted for, but not really in any order. I think you could be pleased with the performance of any of these guys completely. I mean, Richard Pitino's been fantastic with the turnaround, sticking with the game plan. Chris Collins, he should get an award for, I don't know how to call this, what to call it, but almost like Stay the Course Award. I mean, he understood what he was going to do when he got there a few years back, and he stuck with it, and it's sure paid off.
This is an election day. I demand transparency. I want to know who you voted for. And an offensive foul on one end and the same on the other side.
It's an election day. But I'm too sensitive. The people on Twitter get a little bit mad.
You'll tell me after the broadcast, though, right? Maybe?
I'll tell you this. I think Richard Pitino will win the award. That's what I think. I do. I think you can't ignore the turnaround. You can't ignore that this right now looks like one of the most elite Big Ten teams in the conference up there with Purdue. And I think one of the most complete and balanced teams as well.
Of course, hard to argue with those other two guys that he put up there, and Turgeon and Collins likely leading Northwestern to their first ever big dance. Vito Brown can't find the range. He's under 30% from downtown this season.
If you watch Mark Turgeon coach that team yesterday, a very young basketball team all balanced around Mello Trimble, but if you watch him, what a feed, wow. Missed chippy by Eric Kerr, but if you watch the energy, you can see why those young guys buy into playing for Mark Turgeon. So all three of those coaches certainly deserving the award.
It's a big-time game you were at yesterday. Awesome. Trimble with that game-winning shot against Michigan State. And now here in Madison, Badgers down 2. Happ trying to go to work. Had it blocked by Lynch. That's his 102nd block of the season, 102. Best ever in a Minnesota uniform for a single year. And now he's dishing it, and then the extra pass and the finish by Eric Curry. What a nifty sequence from Minnesota.
Well, it's good to see Eric Curry finish that one at the rim, take the contact, and miss the chippy the previous play. I think Minnesota's doing something that a lot of teams struggle to do against Wisconsin, and that is get the ball inside the paint. It's the flash cut. You lose sight of your man, he cuts right to the heart of the defense, and that's why they're able to break you down. Wisconsin typically doesn't let you get into the paint, whether it be with the dribble drive or the pass. And that's why they're so good defensively.
Missed free throw. It's a 10-2 Minnesota run. Keep your eye on the foul situation for Wisconsin. Koenig and Brown, two seniors on senior day, both have a pair. Wisconsin's offense at times, and you've alluded to it, it has looked like it's been tired, struggling, whatever, as of late. The defense was locked in against Iowa. They just couldn't get anything going offensively. And Happ has been facing a lot of double teams, and there's another block shot by Lynch. Dangerous pass ahead does find Mason.
I look right at Richard Pitino, and he's screaming at Reggie Lynch. He made a great play and then gives it away, or nearly gives it away.
Lynch had 11 blocks against Penn State, followed that up with six more against Nebraska. Now Mason with a runner, and Greg Gard needs to take a timeout. It's a 12-2 Minnesota run. Defensively, the man of the year for Minnesota is Mr. Lynch. 14-8 Gophers. Minnesota on a 12-2 spurt, up 14-8. Reggie Lynch, a couple of blocks. We knew that would be a fun battle to watch between he and Happ inside.
Yeah, and so far, I think Reggie Lynch has done a good job avoiding that second foul, staying on the ground, and really just going straight up. He still has the size advantage over Happ. But just wait. If you don't double-team Ethan Happ, he's going to wear you down and break you down.
It's almost a four-minute scoring drought right now for the Badgers. Will that end right here? It does not. Jordan Hill misses. And the groans grow a little louder from the fans here at the Kohl Center. Mason threw a screen, and he airballs.
He even got that blocked or hit on the wrist. He don't miss like that.
How can the Badgers settle in more offensively? What are you seeing from them that's not really fluid?
Not enough movement. There's a lot of standing right now, which allows the defense to cover two with one.
Demetric Trice got caught in the air into Happ. And no on the home roll. The tap back. Yes. Freezing Happ.
Just stays active. He's got such great hands, long arms, but he also reads where the ball's coming off very well.
And that stops the drought. They hadn't had the field goal since the 16-15 mark. Active hands by the freshman. Demetri Trice is going to get Wisconsin the ball back.
Ethan Happ just staying active on the offensive glass. Hasn't come easy. Going to be a tough matchup against Reggie Lynch. But if you get those to go, I'll get you rolling.
Big Ten tournament this coming week in D.C. In the top six, it's not necessarily going to be in that order. Purdue is the number one seed, we know that, but those six are locked into the top six spots.
Yeah, those are some really competitive basketball teams. Those are teams, in my opinion, that can all make noise in the NCAA tournament. There's a few on the outside looking in that are really dangerous, too. You saw one in Iowa today.
All right, there are your week one power rankings. Well, to be fair, I'm trying to cover for you. A lot of people thought Indiana would be near the top of the league.
Whatever. Look, say whatever the heck you want. It's just what I thought at the time.
But it's possible to pick.
And the next week, I was probably even more wrong. It's just how it went this season. It was impossible to pick, especially with injuries. But even more so with just how competitive top to bottom this league was. And I'm going to be wrong next year, so I don't care.
But it's true. A lot of people had Indiana up at the top there. Driving in and fouled is Hayes.
They also beat two top five teams early in the season, so that was validated for a couple weeks. Now they have their struggles, obviously, with injuries, but also just not getting things together with the right core group of guys.
Well, the team that really surprised everybody, at least most people, Minnesota, you didn't have them on that list, and now here they are battling for the two seed in the Big Ten tournament.
I was way off with that one. It's all right. I mean, look, you're not going to get it right all the time. That's what makes basketball fun.
Lynch traveled before putting that shot up. Wisconsin, though, we'll see if they can get their offense on track. They started 2-3. Since then, they're 2-10. And down by 4. Losers of 5-6. Minnesota on that 8-game win streak. Hayes driving, no good, through two defenders, but Happ there for the offensive board and the kick out. Hayes will pull from inside, no good. Early in the year, Hayes was putting up a lot of outside shots. That has since waned, but he hit one earlier from just inside the arc. And on the other end, Eric Curry with a reverse.
The transition offense got all the way inside to the foul line. And Curry just found an easy layup because of a great pass by Mir Coffey.
Mir Coffey averages 3 assists a game. Got one there. Midway through the first half. The 201st meeting. The first one, as Hayes is short on another long jumper. First meeting was back in 1900.
Where were you?
I was there. It was 17-15 in Minneapolis. It was a heck of a game. That is a true story, although I was not present. Were you present?
No, my family was still farming at that time.
Pass inside, knocked loose and taken by Happ, and he gives to Demetri Trice. Point being, there are not many secrets. Wisconsin has won 6 straight.
Well, I also think that's what makes this Big Ten Conference. You see great feet and finish. Ethan Happ with a phenomenal steal. That's what he does so well. Much like an Isaac Haas, he gives you a target hand. And if you throw it anywhere in the vicinity, he's going to catch it. It's part of what makes him so tough to defend.
Akeem Springs, the grad transfer. His specialty is three-pointers, not that time. But Dupree McGrayer was saying, his classmates all week have been saying, just please beat Wisconsin. Yeah. Great, you won 8 straight, just please beat Wisconsin.
Because it's that easy, right?
Especially at the Kohl Center.
Senior night, yeah, sure.
That's going to be a foul on Eric Curry. The rivalry, it's been tight in basketball. It's also been really tight in football. It's about as close as you can get in both.
That's incredible. That really is incredible. I mean, the fact that there's ties, too. I still can't believe they're ties. You got to have a winner, right?
Wisconsin has also won 12 straight in football, so they've dominated each as of late. I know the Minnesota fans don't want to hear that. Catching and shooting in the corner. Boy, Wisconsin is cold. 5 of 18, including 1 of 5 from outside the arc after that Showalter miss. And Nigel Hayes picks up his first personal.
Yeah, one of the things with this Big Ten Conference is the teams figure each other out so well. And that's what makes it a challenge. They figure out what you struggle with. This is going to be a push on Nigel Hayes. Nothing egregious, but a foul nonetheless. This Big Ten conference is tough because everybody figures each other out, especially when you've seen them twice already. And I think for Wisconsin, they just got to get the heck out of the conference. I think they'd really start to thrive a little bit more. Same could be said for Purdue. No one realizes how difficult and good Purdue is.
So you think the NCAA tournament could be a breath of fresh air for a lot of teams?
Yeah, I think the NCAA tournament is comfort zone for Wisconsin. Maybe not so much for Purdue. We understand their history.
And Purdue will be the one seed in D.C. in the Big Ten tournament. Regular season champs, we do know that. The two seed is on the line here. The winner gets the two seed. If Minnesota loses, they will be the four seed. Pass inside, going up. Off the bench, no good for Bakari Konate. And then a foul on the rebound, and that's going to go against Eric Curry. That's his second.
That's just not a smart foul. Really, it's not. There's no reason for it. Nigel Hayes is pretty sure-handed. He got the rebound. Just get back and play defense. No reason to pick up your second foul.
It has gone final, by the way. Purdue did beat Northwestern, so that means that the winner of this game is the two seed. The loser is the four seed. That's it. Those are the only scenarios left. I like when it's simple.
Yeah, but you know, you got to look at this, saying the winner is the two seed, and the loser is going to have to face Purdue early.
That's a good point as well.
And lo and behold, you got to beat whoever your opponent is anyway. You got to beat the best anyway. But still, there's something about it, finding a little bit of rhythm and winning in a championship game situation.
After that free throw miss, Hayes, 7 of his last 18 over the last three games. Not the numbers that the Badgers were hoping for.
That's putting it lightly. That was very generous of you.
Mason straight on, fading away and burying it.
That's my Mason.
I think it's a combination of things. It's very mental, but I also think they're struggling to find rhythm within the offense. And the better rhythm you have offensively, the easier it's going to be to shoot foul shots.
Backing up, Trice, no good. He's their best three-point shooter by the numbers at 43%. It goes out of bounds. It'll stay with Wisconsin.
Hey, you talk about rhythm offensively. Well, Nate Mason, he makes his own rhythm. Kind of makes his own beat. Step-back jumpers, he's got it going tonight.
Starting Wednesday night, 7 Eastern on BTN and BTN to go. So here's what we know. Purdue will be the one seed. Maryland will actually be the three seed. Yep. So it's kind of confusing, but the winner of our game here will jump up to the two. Maryland will go to the three, and the loser of our game will be the four seed. Got all that?
Sure. I understand it. Part of me just wants to show up and call the games, right? Yeah. You know, it's going to be what it is. And it doesn't matter with the seedings. Anybody can beat anybody.
Half inside, and that is a rarity because the last 8 shots for them have been jumpers or three-pointers.
Yeah, I think it's a combination of taking what the defense gives you and the defense doing a good job of giving you what you don't want. Try to figure that out. It totally makes sense, but might have talked a little too fast on that one.
Hep has 6 points, 4 rebounds now. He had a heck of a game the first time these two hooked up, 28 points. There's Mason. That's he now Mason. Has 8 to lead all scorers. But the first game these two teams met on January 21st, Hap 28 points, 12 rebounds, 6 assists, 5 blocks. Pretty good.
Yeah, those are good numbers.
The freshman, Demetric Trice.
And I think that's exactly what Trice has to do. If you can use that high ball screen, turn the corner, get all the way to the rim, not only is it going to open up layup opportunities, it's going to open up better jump shoots, rhythm jump shooting opportunities.
And there's a block for Hap. And what a heady play.
That's a great play.
He threw it off of Mason.
It's a play that they're finally starting to figure out. Because remember the days so long ago, like a couple years ago, when you used to jump out of bounds, fall into the 6th row and call timeout, and they give it to you. Well, now you just throw it off of somebody else that's out of bounds. That's hilarious. It's a great play.
It was a great play indeed by the redshirt sophomore from Illinois.
I don't care. I did the broadcaster thing that you're not supposed to do. I said, great play. I don't care. That was a great play.
Up top, Vito Brown trying to get it into half, but Lynch is draped all over him. They do get it down there. Here comes the double and the kick. Vito Brown.
Smile on Vito Brown. bit of a smile because I think the crowd finally got behind these guys. It's been a struggle. Shooting the basketball has been an absolute struggle, whether it's been a jump shot or a foul shot. Good to see one go for Vito Brown.
Moment ago, inside-out game for Vito Brown.
Yeah, how about the four and the five, man, working the inside-out game? And Vito Brown's the kind of guy, if he gets going shooting the basketball, he'd become a really good basketball team, and Mom loves it. She wasn't too sure about his solo performance at National Anthem. She gave him a B. Not tonight, I'm not talking about. I'm talking about a couple years ago. She wasn't too sure about that performance, but she likes seeing the shot go down.
Yeah, she looked as relieved as anyone. Wisconsin was 1 of 7 from long range, now 2 of 8. And back within a penny at 20-19, and there is life in the Kohl Center. Curry, high off the glass. No, Lynch had it stripped. Look at the battle. Boy, these teams are fighting. Shot clock violation because the ball never hit the rim on Curry's shot. So far, this is what we expected, a knockdown dragout.
And I think for Wisconsin, it's good to get the crowd back into it. I understand the frustration, but you need the support. You need the energy of the crowd, especially when you struggle.
Wisconsin's hit their last 3 shots after that long cold spell. Trice driving on the taller Curry. Mason knocking it free. Here goes Dupree McBrayer. It'll be left for Mason, and he buries it from the right way.
It's amazing how you get really good 3-point opportunities in transition. I think more and more coaches are getting comfortable with the transition 3. I think it's one of the best shots at basketball outside of a layup or dunk.
Mason's very good at it, and he now has 11 points.
I'm clearly biased. It's the only thing I could do.
Well, you were pretty good at it as well, so it worked.
It's because it was the only thing I could do.
Zach Showalter finishing on the other side of the rim. Showalter, the former walk-on. What a big day this is for him. A couple walk-on years and then exploding the last couple onto the scene for this Badger program.
And Showalter's a great story. He's a former walk-on. He still plays like a walk-on, and I mean that in the most complimentary way. He does all the little things well. He gets down and dirty. He takes charges. He mixes it up. He rebounds. He goes to the basket hard. He plays as if he's got something to prove every single possession. I think that's the type of guy. His energy is something that everybody should follow.
And because of that, he's earned his 66th consecutive start in this game, as McBrayer misses the first.
There's a lot of trust in that many starts in a row. And the trust is that of the coaching staff. It looks at a guy and says, might not be the best scorer in the world, might not be the biggest guy in the world, but I trust you on the floor in any position.
And he held Peter Jacques to 8 points on 2 of 10 shooting, albeit in a loss against Iowa here the other day.
How about that Iowa team? Hey, it's just, I'm really predicting that within 2 years, they are either going to win or finish second in the Big Ten. I really do. I think they're going to compete for a Big Ten title.
Inside, and it's 5 straight field goal makes for Wisconsin. That one was the easiest.
And Nigel Hayes did a great job keeping position. Jordan Murphy got beat the second he gave up position.
A rim-rocking slam from Nigel Hayes. And the offense clicking all of a sudden for the Badgers. Mason to the corner for Coffey. Strong. Can they make it 6 consecutive field goal makes? Look at that. 5 of 20 was the start of the game. Here's Happ. Yes. First lead since it was 8-7 for Wisconsin. Was standing and they will sit as Lynch is fouled.
Yeah, they're able to get Nigel Hayes a basket because Nigel Hayes took advantage of a defense that lost position. You give up position on Nigel Hayes, he's just too good and you don't want to let him get rolling. There's another guy you don't want to let get rolling, Ethan Happ. Another guy, he gets great position, he's impossible to stop. Man.
Tune in to WGN America for an all-new season of Underground coming March 8th. Here's the Kohl Center, Wisconsin on an 11-4 run, and there are Jerry Palm's tournament seed projections. What do you think?
Well, I kind of laugh at this one. The Illini, they earned themselves a spot, and then they lose to Rutgers, and now they're the first of the first four out. That's what I laugh about. What does that feel like? Are you glass half full or glass half empty with that one? Because I look at it and go, wait, we're the first of all the guys that don't get to play in the NCAA tournament? Or you say, hey, we're still there, which means if we go down and handle our business in D.C., we could get back in the mix.
And what about Michigan State?
I think Michigan State's an NCAA tournament team. You play the schedule that they played. If anything, the NCAA should thank them for what they took on in November.
And then they started conference play with a win at Minnesota. They beat Minnesota twice to Michigan State, beat Wisconsin, beat Northwestern. Sitting at 18-13, 10-8 in the conference, Tom Izzo's team. But, hey, there's going to be a lot of teams with a lot to play for in D.C. next week. Ethan Happ can't finish. Crowd thought he was fouled. Got his own miss. Kicked it out to Trice. And Trice will reset. Iowa getting the win today against Penn State at home. And that got them to 10 wins in the league as well.
I'm going to say, I don't want to speak too soon because Brady Lynch will end up picking up a foul. I think he's done a good job contesting shots at the rim without fouling. And that's a tough thing to do.
Lynch and Happ each with one foul. Lynch way off there. Out to Coffey, though. That'll work. Nice job by Eric Curry to scoop up the rebound and dish it out to him.
Oh, that play was so broken that the defense had no idea where to go. Put him in a scramble situation, and Coffey gets wide open.
State Farm halftime report coming up. Dave Revson, Mike DeCourcy, Jess Settles in Chicago. Showalter with the basket for Wisconsin. They're right back within two, inside of 2 minutes to go in the first half. Dupree McBrayer deflected underneath to Curry. He can't finish. Boy, everything at the rim is contested on both sides. Pass up ahead. Beautiful feed, and Happ got fouled. But Dimitri tries to set it all up with a chest pass over the top.
The Minnesota Falcons number two, Nate Mason, is first.
Take a look at this. This is a simple flex cut. A freeze right here. This is going to be an easy screen. Joey's going to come off and get himself a wide-open layup. You can't draw it up. This is one of the simplest plays to defend. If you're Dupree McBrayer, you're two, three passes away. You got to jump into the paint and keep yourself from being screened. The last thing you want to do if you're Minnesota is to give up layups. Give up jump shots all night. Don't give up layups.
McBrayer sits as Happ missed the first free throw. Mentioned he was 1-7 from the line of the loss to Iowa on Thursday. Just 48% for Happ this year. And he misses both. Well, nobody wants to make those more than Ethan Happ. And that's what his coach said at shoot-around. And that's an obvious statement, but he's as frustrated as anyone. Mason. Around the arc to Coffey. Hit a three a moment ago. This time he penetrates, fades. And corralling the rebound, Ethan Happ. Neck and neck first half. A very physical first half. Great no-look dish. Oh, Happ missed the bunny and spoiled an assist for Trice. So instead of a tie game, Minnesota can push it to a two-score lead. Stripping it, Vito Brown. Nothing is easy, is it?
No, not at all.
Trice. Strong. Shot clock off. And Minnesota and Amir Coffey will hold for that final attempt.
I think Wisconsin, in a way, should feel pretty good. As poorly as they've shot the basketball, they executed well enough to get enough layups and shots at the rim to keep themselves in this game. And I think within striking distance here, as I said before, the hottest team in the Big Ten right now, Minnesota.
Wisconsin's under 40%. Downtown three, end of the first half, no good for Nate Mason. A good first half for Mason, though. He does have 11 points to lead all scorers, and Minnesota is up by 2, 29-27. Number 2 seed on the line here in Madison. When we come back, we'll toss it to Chicago for our State Farm Halftime Report with Dave Redson, Mike DeCorsi, and Jeff Settle. Basketball on BTN is brought to you in part by Auto Owners Insurance, the no-problem people. Find your agent at autoowners.com. And in partnership with Rocket Mortgage by Quicken Loans. Push button, get mortgage. Intermission and Madison. Two-point game, Minnesota 29 and the Badgers 27. We are courtside here at the Kohl Center. Hello, everybody. With John Crispin, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Winner of this game gets a 2 seed in the Big Ten tournament. The loser, the 4 seed. The first 20 minutes looked like they were playing for a lot.
Yeah, they sure were. Nate Mason was fantastic doing what he does. I think Wisconsin's going to have to win this game with layups. Minnesota's going to win it with jump shots. If they can continue to get jump shots to fall, they're really tough to stop. Because the more they get jump shots to fall, the better spacing they have, the more they pull the defense away from the basket. That's when they start to carve you up. So I think if Nate Mason can continue to do what he's been able to do in the first half, it should probably go Minnesota's way.
Here's what he's done during the 8-game winning streak. I guess that's good. That's what you want, right? Those numbers, right there.
Yes, you are exactly right. And that number, 19.4 points a game, that is the most in the Big Ten since the beginning of February.
He's the only double-figure scorer on either side. But the two teams in the first half, a combined 40%, including a combined 4 of 15 from outside the arc. And here's a defensive play to start the second 20, a steal by Nate Mason.
And you got to think Bronson Koenig's struggling, just moving around. I mean, he only played 5 minutes in the first half. 0-1 shooting, and it's just not really there. Just not the same guy he's been.
That's exactly right. He had the 2 fouls, was forced to sit.
But he just seems a little step behind the play, and you got to feel for him. You know, you've seen him play at such a higher level, just not getting the separation in the lift.
There's some lift.
What the heck am I talking about?
He heard you, John Crispin. His 243rd three-pointer, of course, just adding on to his school record.
Yeah, it's a tough shot, too. He got a tough shot to go.
Speaking of tough shots, ooh, an air ball. Maybe a little too tough for Nate Mason.
Just as I'm saying, oh, he's not getting the lift, he's not getting the separation, he gets just enough separation and clearly just enough lift. Whatever, I'll just stop talking.
Part of that four-man senior class honored before the game. They've won 110 games, the most ever for a senior class, 115. The 2015 crew did that. Nate Mason with a full head of steam.
Basket by Mason.
Mason now has a baker's dozen. Showalter searches for space, hits Hap. Hap and Lynch have been going at it all game, and the help side defense of Murphy ties him up.
You're going to see what opponents can do against Wisconsin when you're not so fearful of giving up jump shots. You're able to just converge on the ball once it gets into the paint, and that's exactly what Jordan Murphy did.
January 21st, these two teams went to overtime in the barn. Wisconsin won by 2. That game had 18 ties and 16 lead changes. Here we've had 3 ties and 4 lead changes so far. Mason splits and kicks. Spring steps back off the right side. And we're going the other way.
The ways to beat Wisconsin is to beat them in transition. Make it a full court game, because when you have to face Wisconsin's defense in a half court, it just gets tougher and tougher as the game goes on. So for Minnesota, if you get a rebound, you've got to get out and run.
To your point, Wisconsin does not have a fast break point. Minnesota has 5 so far.
Number 3, Jordan Murphy is third. The team's first.
Jordan Murphy commits the foul. That is the third on Murphy, so he's going to have to sit.
And if you're Richard Pitino, you watch these back and you show your guys saying, why pick up that foul? You don't have position. It's not going to be a steal and a run out and a dunk. Why pick it up? You're more valuable when you're playing on the floor.
Koenig swatted by Reggie Lynch. His third rejection of the game. Mason out for Springs. And then Lynch fumbled it. Knocked out. Vito Brown was frustrated. He couldn't hang on to that.
This one really didn't have a chance. You go in there. You see Reggie Lynch. He's just as calm as it gets. Just swat shots. But he always has an eye on the ball handler. I think that's something that goes kind of underrated about his defense. He always has an eye on the ball.
Because of him, Minnesota an eyelash better than Oregon. Wow. 7.1 blocks a game for most in the country. And then Coffey with a tough finish off the window.
Yeah, well, having 11 blocks and no fouls against Penn State certainly doesn't hurt that cause.
And then following it up with six against Nebraska. Three more here. He's defending the post here in half. Half spins away from him, but he blocks the shot again.
It was a terrific post move by Ethan Happ. He felt the defender. He spins off knowing that based on the physical contact he's got, he's going to be able to turn and beat them baseline. But Reggie Lynch has just enough separation to not hit you with the body. But good timing, good length. Still gets a block shot.
Three and a half a game. You see the mark. And there's a three-pointer on the mark for Bronson Koenig. He's hit two. All even at 33. Mason wants to change that. He cannot. Koenig, does he want to pull it? Well, he passed it off and gets it back. Happ, an extra pass. Is it knocked out? No, they say it was not deflected. It will be Minnesota ball.
And it's good to see Bronson Koenig get involved in the offense because that's what opened things up. We talked about Minnesota and their ability to make, jump shots and how it opens up driving lanes, opens up one-on-one opportunities down low in the paint. Well, that's exactly what needs to happen for Wisconsin as well. I mean, yeah, Nigel Hayes, Ethan Happ, they're working against four down there in the paint.
That was the sixth Wisconsin turnover. They had 11 against Iowa, which is right around their season average, but they had three costly ones late. There's a tip shot by Brown. Nice defensive play. Hayes against the smaller Coffey. Smaller muscle-wise, not height. And then the pass into Happ is knocked into the corner. He tracks it down with 10 to shoot. Hayes will release. Said it in the first half. Early in the season, he was taking a lot of those jumpers. Didn't have much success. Stopped shooting him. He hits one there.
You got to shoot the shots that you get when they're open. That's what changes the game. If you don't shoot them, you become a liability on the floor.
Springs is very good from distance, but that one is short. Wisconsin was 2 of 8 from outside the arc in the first half. They're 3 of 3 so far in the second. One by Hayes, two by this man, Koenig, up top to Showalter. Happ fouled.
And it's senior day. Now your seniors are finally getting involved in this game. Bronson Koenig, I said he wasn't getting enough separation. Well, he's certainly getting enough here in the second half. And Nigel Hayes, if you're open, you got to shoot it. He gets it to go. 3-point lead for the Badgers.
Tonight, and Wisconsin is up by 3. And their parents scattered throughout the audience for those 4.
If you think this game doesn't mean a little something extra to those seniors and to those parents, you're out of your mind. I can tell you my brother knows exactly what happened in his senior day at Penn State. We lost against Ohio State. He remembers every shot he missed. This definitely means a little something extra, not just because you're playing your rival. It's the last time you're going to play on this floor. The amount of time you've put into what you're doing right now, as you see the crowd goes crazy for Ethan Happ as he made a foul shot. Put so much time in preparing to perform on this floor. That it means a lot.
Happ got his own rebound on the miss on try number two. So the crowd happy about that as well after groaning on the miss. He's just two of his last 14 from the line, though, is Ethan Happ.
It's hard to believe.
Koenig, 3 feet behind the arc.
That was the old picket fences right there. That was the Hoosiers. Jimmy Chitwood, I'm not talking about the Indiana Hoosiers. I'm going back a little bit. Jimmy Chitwood, Hickory Hoosiers.
You're talking Gene Hackman's Hoosiers.
Yes, yes.
Not Tom Green. The other way, Nigel Hayes. 4-point lead right now. Try to make it 7. 10-0 Wisconsin run. Largest lead of the game for the Badgers. Richard Pitino takes the timeout. That's rocking in Madison.
Successful senior classes in Wisconsin basketball history. You know you're going to rely on them down the stretch to make big plays, to right the ship, so to speak, especially headed into postseason play. And they've done just that. Everybody getting involved. Vito Brown got involved the first half. It's been Showalter, Hayes, and Bronson Koenig making perimeter jump shots. And that's why they got a 7-point lead.
Four of those 6 3-pointers here as we take a look at the Principal Financial Group game summary. But four of those 6 3-pointers here in the second half for Wisconsin. And the senior class with 29 combined points.
29 of 40, not bad. And the other guy out there is Ethan Happ. He's pretty good, too.
Happ has 9. Trice has 2. That's all the scoring for Wisconsin. Mason is the leader for Minnesota. He now has 15.
He is the leader in every single way. I mean, coming out of the timeout, set play, reads it well, curls in there, and makes a tough shot.
Stopped a 3.5-minute scoring drought for the Gophers. First half, Wisconsin had a 4-minute scoring drought, so each team has had their struggles offensively. Into the game and making a turnover, Khalil Iverson. Coffey tries to take advantage. Shot was altered and he missed. Here comes the double team again on half, and he throws it away. Mason fouled on the way to the rim.
Those are transition opportunities that Minnesota's got to continue to take advantage of, especially off of a turnover where defense is trailing the play. I think Ethan Happ just has to be a little bit more patient. When the double comes, the dribble out often gives you better passing lanes. It's an interesting situation where you're able to play behind with Reggie Lynch. You don't have to fight over the top to keep passes from entering the post. You can play behind and just wait for the double to come.
Mason 7 of 14 from the field and hits his first free throw attempt. Tonight, an all-new episode of BTN's original The Journey, Big Ten Basketball 2017. And then our hoops experts will cover the major topics in college basketball on Big Ten Basketball and Beyond, starting at 10 Eastern on BTN.
The Journey does such a great job of kind of getting another layer deep, right? And you just peel back a layer and you learn a little something about... Gosh, Nate Mason misses 2 in a row there. You learn a little bit something more about some of these kids. You realize they're people with struggles and they've overcome things. And
yeah, it's very cool to see the human interest element of some of these guys. Get to see what they're like off the court. Mason, 81% shooter, as you said. Rare that he misses both, but he did. Late shot clock. Trice. And the foul. And not only the foul, but it's on Murphy, and that's his fourth.
And that kills, because when this team, in terms of Minnesota, plays well, it's usually because Jordan Murphy's doing what he does. Talk about the last 8 games, 15.5 points, 12.5 rebounds a game. you average a double-double like that with all the supporting cast members that you have for Minnesota, you're going to win a lot of basketball games. But with him being off the floor, it's going to be a challenge. They're going to have to really rely on Eric Curry to bring him home.
The new fashion four-point play for Demetric Trice. Mason, no. You're right, though. Murphy to the bench with just 4 points and two rebounds. Stark contrast to what he's been doing. A little behind-the-back sizzle. And then a one-handed dish. And Trice with a finish. McBrayer can't quiet the crowd. Another stop for the Wisconsin defense. Inside! Vito Brown! One-handed flush. It's an 18-2 run, Wisconsin. Timeout, Minnesota.
Brandon, you just said something I don't think I've ever heard. At the Kohl Center, you said a little sizzle. You said sizzle from the Badgers. And no sizzle here at Kohl Center. They're having some fun, and I think that's exactly what this fan base has been looking for.
And that's why they got a big lead.
Senior Vito Brown's parents like him what they're seeing. 21-6 in the second half in favor of Wisconsin, and now they're up 13. These two teams playing for the 2 seed or the 4 seed. Winner gets the 2 seed, loser gets the 4 seed.
This looked like the Wisconsin team that was number 7 in the nation at one point this season. I think even at that time, we questioned, are they really that good? Can they score enough points to be a top 10 team? They won enough games to get there, but certainly when the top 16 came out, and the NCAA announced the top 16 early, obviously it's going to change. It has since changed. Wisconsin was a top 10 team, and they weren't even in the mix.
Started out Big Ten play so hot. 10-1, lost 5 of 6 now. Minnesota, of course, has won 8 straight to get to 11-6 in the league. Tough shot for DeBree McBrayer.
It's Jamal Crawford. Just call him Jamal Crawford. He comes in, he's just a bucket getter. He can defend. He's got great legs. He's athletic. He's a Division I basketball player, but he really just comes in. It's instant offense.
Last 4 games for McBrayer, 15, 18, 15, and 16 points. So you are exactly right. In this game, though, he just has 3. Nigel Hayes did everything but finish. A nice move. Couldn't get it to drop. Here's McBrayer again going for buckets. He gets fouled.
He just plays downhill. He really just continues to come at you. But I want to go back to something you said, and I got all excited about it going to the break. You mentioned the sizzle. And I think as much as I joked about it, I think that's something that's been seriously lacking. I think it's been lacking for the fan base. I think it's been lacking for the players. So much attention's been on whether you can make a jump shot or not, whether you can make a foul shot or not. But I think you still have to go out and have fun. And it sounds really simplistic, but you have to go out and enjoy what you're doing playing the basketball game. And if you do, probably going to make more shots.
And it's been fun for these fans of these Badgers here in the second half. First half was a grind. Second half's been all Badgers. Active hands by Happ knocks it out with 21 to shoot.
But it all comes down to energy. What type of energy are you playing with? It's a psychological thing, yes, but it's also what drives your performance. And if you don't believe that, you've never played sports.
I trust you. I played Little League. That was blocked out of bounds.
Yeah, but if you wanted to hit the baseball, you had to have good energy. You couldn't walk up there going, there's not a chance I'm going to hit this kid. You're going to strike out.
Koenig with a recovery there. Lynch, shot fake. Through the contact of Happ, couldn't get it.
And Wisconsin doing a better job defensively, not over-helping, not giving second-chance opportunities, forcing tough shots. It's what they're known for.
15-4 rebounding this second half in favor of Wisconsin. Partially blocked by Lynch, getting it back, trying to slam it. Iverson could not, but then a whistle.
Who wants it for? Jordan Iverson's not the biggest guy in that mix right there, yet he made it a point that he was going to get that ball one way or another. And he didn't just try to lay it up.
He went in strong. There's opportunity number one. He's fighting for it, and he's going straight vert you.
You know what that means? Straight vert. He's no step.
Vertical.
Just straight
just
up.
Straight up.
Just yeah. Straight up. No step. No dribble. No lining your feet up.
Speaking of sizzle, he wanted to put some sizzle in that steak right there. Sophomore been fighting for minutes, played a season low 4 minutes against Iowa and did not score, and he misses two at the line there. Mason knows what he wants to do with it, but he cannot finish. Straight up defense by Showalter. Here goes Iverson. Wow. Well, they say he's arguably the most athletic guy on the team. He shows you why. See if he can do better at the line this go around.
Wisconsin, I don't want to say it the wrong way. They're not known for having athletes, so when you have a guy like Khalil Iverson, a guy like Orlando Tucker back in the day, it wasn't that long ago, but back in the day, they really jump out at you.
Free throw woes continue. Wisconsin is 3 of 11 at the line. Minnesota not a whole lot better at 5 of 10. And you get the sarcastic cheers every time a free throw is made here at the Kohl Center.
It doesn't make it any easier.
Minnesota just 2 of their last 12. Coffee to the line.
I do like what Minnesota's doing offensively. They're getting to the basket. They're looking to score quickly. Still playing with pace. You can't just slow things down and take the tempo out of the game, especially on the offensive end, just because that's what Wisconsin's going to do to you.
Tonight on BTN, we close out the regular season with Ty Webster, Nebraska, hosting Derek Walton, Michigan. Coverage starts after our game on BTN, of course, also streaming live on BTN to go. With our friends Kevin Kugler and Sean Morris on the call.
Kugler makes the long drive from Omaha over there to Lincoln. Have you ever been to Lincoln? Lincoln's a really cool place.
It is.
It's a really cool
place. That Haymarket District area.
Haymarket District. Never did I think I'd ever find my favorite sushi restaurant in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Right next there to the Courtyard Hotel?
Yeah, heck yeah. Blue Sushi right there.
Yeah, it's a good spot.
I feel like a hipster when I'm eating sushi there, but still good.
Stolen away by Amir Coffey. Blocked by Koenig, his second of the game. Cross-court skip. And it's blocked this time by Showalter. He saves it, though, to McBrayer. And McBrayer, after all that, scores and is fouled. What a sequence.
Two blocks by guard. Showalter stays with the play. You know Akeem Springs, if he gets a look, he's got to shoot it. And he almost keeps the thing alive, but McBrayer stays with it. You know what he's trying to do? Score.
Both of his field goals here in the second half for the sophomore from Queens, New York.
I still think the difference maker is no Jordan Murphy. Jordan Murphy with four fouls, two of which just were careless fouls, and it puts him on the bench. He's been so important to their success, winning 8 games in a row, and he's been double-double machine.
And in those limited minutes, just 1 of 2 and 4 points for Murphy. Less than 9 minutes to play, and an 8-point lead for Wisconsin. Showalter thought about it. Good recovery by Springs. 5 to shoot. Runner, no. Put back, yes. Khalil Iverson.
That's a help-to-helper situation. You beat your initial defender. Help comes over to block the shot. No one's there to take Khalil Iverson away. Almost like a lob opportunity.
First basket for Iverson. Averages 4 a contest. Now Springs. Knocked to the ground. Every rebound is an absolute battle, and half stepped out. There's Murphy. All he can do right now with the 4 fouls is watch and chew that gum.
I feel as if there's a piece of Minnesota that understands that a 10-point game against Wisconsin feels more like a 20-point game against anybody else, where it really is a struggle to score when Wisconsin gets locked in defensively.
And that's why, as the miss by Lynch comes, when Wisconsin got up late against Iowa, it just felt like a 30-point lead, and then Iowa scored the last 7 points and stole the game.
Oh, Iowa's fearless. I mean, they're so young that they just fear nothing, and they just continue to attack.
Speaking of attacking, McBrayer. You said he comes in and gets buckets. He is driving the ball as Dupree McBrayer. Two seed is on the line of the Big Ten tournament. You can tell there is emotion in the Kohl Center on the last day of the regular season. Basketball on BTN is brought to you in part by State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800 State Farm. A lot of energy in the Kohl Center. Our auto owners, game leaders, one of the seniors for Wisconsin, Nigel Hayes, and then Nate Mason, the junior for Minnesota.
I just want to go back to what you just said. In terms of the energy here in the Kohl Center, I think the energy, and it's not a knock on fans being frustrated with the foul shooting. I get it, but I also understand what you feel as a player shooting. When the fans moan and groan every time you miss a shot, it does take a little something out of you. So I think it's key for these players to get a few shots to fall, to feel some positive energy back in this building again. Because remember, this is a place that they understand what it takes to win at a high level. They demand that and they expect that. You look at the success they've had over the last few years.
Vito Brown sitting with four fouls. And Greg Gard said at shoot around, you know, I get it. I was here with Bo Ryan. He and I, you know, and the other assistants and the players built something special to where the fans just expect excellence here year in and year out.
Well, I mean, that's the whole idea, right? Chris Collins is trying to do the same thing at Northwestern. Is the year he makes the NCAA tournament, which is going to be this year, they're going to demand and expect that every single year from now on out. And if he don't go to Sweet 16, they're going to wonder what's wrong with you. I mean, I was at UCLA with Steve Lavin, and he went to 5 out of 6 Sweet 16s, and everybody wanted him to be fired. 5 out of 6 Sweet 16s. Well, the reason being, there's 11 national championship banners hanging in Pauley Pavilion.
And you saw the streak that just flashed on the screen there for Wisconsin. So impressive. 17th year with a Big Ten winning record. A very rare air ball from Koenig. Great hustle from Showalter, and then Koenig missed again.
How about Showalter? Like I said, still plays as if he's a walk-on with a giant chip on his shoulder, something to prove.
McBrayer falling away from 18 feet off the mark. Minnesota shooting 32.7% from the floor. Wisconsin 42%. But the second half has been the difference. Minnesota 5 of 23, the Badgers 8 of 17. Seven to shoot. The senior Hayes, short. Hayes has 10 points. He and Showalter. That's the top number for Wisconsin. 15 for Mason on the side of Minnesota. He's the points leader for them. But Mason getting a seat on the bench right now as Coffey fires and drains it.
I keep going back to it. Minnesota's got to win with jump shots. If you don't have it in transition, you can't get the basket in transition. You've got to make jump shots. You got Nate Mason coming back in. And that big shot by Amir Coffey just buys you a little more time with Nate Mason on the bench.
Minnesota 3 of 13 from deep now after that make. 13 points, by the way, for Coffey. He's having a night's game. And he had 19 the first time these two teams met. That's on Reggie Lynch. His third.
Team 6.
Those are the fouls you don't want Reggie Lynch to pick up because you understand how aggressive and difficult to defend Ethan Happ is. You want Reggie Lynch to play the entire game with one or two fouls.
Happ has two on the other end. This time a bad inbound pass picked up by Curry. Minnesota right back in this thing. Ball hits the deck though and a bad turnover. Boy, Hayes had Showalter with his hands up in the corner, but couldn't get the pass to him. Second foul for Mason. That's now 17 fouls, so Wisconsin will shoot the rest of the way. Murphy sitting with four. Curry with three and Lynch with three.
That might be the story of the game. I mean, Jordan Murphy not really being an impact. Because when he's an impact, they win. They win 8 straight. When he's not an impact, they lose 5 in a row.
And that was the losing streak, as you noted earlier, prior to this 8-game win streak for Minnesota. But 23 losses last year, now 23 wins this year for Minnesota.
It's
also hard to believe that as poorly as Wisconsin has shot the basketball, not just tonight, but really all season, they're going to call the offensive foul. I don't know about it. That's four on Reggie Lynch. That's why I say you want him to play the entire game with two fouls.
The team said,
you know you're going to take the fall. It's not a charge. It's not.
It helps when the defender's 170 pounds and the offensive player's 260.
And from Minnesota, Bakari Konate.
It's just tough. It looks like a charge, but it's really not. It's a great defensive play by Jametric Trice. It really is. I don't want to take anything away from that.
Lynch has fouled out of 8 games this season. He's had 4 fouls in 7 more games. So that's half the year that when the final horn sounds, he has 4 or 5 fouls. Showalter, that was nice.
You got no rim protector. You don't have Reggie Lynch out there. He just picked up his 4th foul, and you have no Jordan Murphy. So you better work and continue to try to keep that ball in front.
Does that mean a lot more drives to the basket now for Wisconsin?
Oh, I sure would.
Less than 5 minutes to play. Wisconsin up 8 points in the paint. First time these two teams played, it was plus 20 points in the paint for Wisconsin. Minnesota wanted a whistle there, no call. Back to Wisconsin. That was the difference on January 21st. 44 points in the paint for Wisconsin, 28 of them coming from half. 24 for Minnesota. Baseline jumper. Tap out by Hayes after the Brown miss.
You just see, if you look at the paint, it's wide open. I mean, the spacing's been good offensively for Wisconsin, and it probably goes back to the fact they made a few jump shots in the second half. There it is. It's just wide open in the paint.
And why not do that? Koenig, though, can't hit the reverse.
But you have to continue to take advantage of that. The paint is wide open. Spacing's been good. Carve up the defense.
Stopping and popping. Mason in and out. Big number 21 that's backing up Reggie Lynch is Bakari Konate, but he's just a 10-minute-a-game guy and only gives you less than 2 points of contest.
You got Reggie Lynch and Jordan Murphy getting ready to check back in with 3.5 minutes left.
And one. Nigel Hayes got hit in the face and finished through the contact.
Yeah, he got his face palmed. But he gets the bucket to go, and you have to take advantage and continue to extend this lead with Jordan Murphy, Reggie Lynch on the bench. They're coming back in.
Thanks, Dave. Should be a great one, as you said. Michigan hoping to get to win number 20. Here, Wisconsin looking for win number 23, up by 10 points on senior day. And our Motel 6-6 man is Travis Trice's baby brother, Dimitric, the freshman.
Man, Dimitric Trice was huge in the first half with Bronson Koenig only playing 5 minutes with foul trouble. Really kept things going. Yeah, kept his foot on the gas, defended well. Kept his team in the mix, and that's what allowed them to come out in the second half, kind of within striking distance, come out and make some shots and take control of this game.
Wisconsin, 4 of 13 at the line, 4 of 14 at the line.
You got to wonder if you're going to start fouling down the stretch. You're down 10. You need to extend the basketball game.
A good point. Do you just start putting Wisconsin at the line here in the next minute or so?
I'm wondering if that's why even Happ's on the bench. You understand that. That's a strategy, but Nigel Hayes has also been in that mix, too.
Minnesota 3-minute scoring drought. Well, there's no drought for Wisconsin right now. Bronson Koenig with his 3rd triple.
Seems like all he does is hit big shots. Right? I mean, we understand that. He's shooting over 50% in the last 5 minutes of games from three. See Nate Mason just carving up the defense, but you got to get stops. Can't trade buckets.
Mason has 17 to lead all scorers. That's why they call Bronson Koenig Clutch Koenig. Of course, his maybe most notable shot, the game-winning 3 against Xavier that sent him to the Sweet 16 last year.
You got to know, you can't go underneath. And you got a little bit of a mismatch there. You got Jordan Murphy on Bronson Koenig. There's no switch. Reggie Lynch got caught behind the screen. So did Jordan Murphy. And Koenig just does his business.
And there's Bronson's mother, Ethel. Senior day, the 4 seniors looking for win number 111. School record 115. Koenig again. High fives all around for Mom. No for Coffee. Murphy back in there where he's so effective underneath the rim, he'll head to the line.
Just feel as if there's a huge sigh of relief here in the building from the fans. The Badger faithful, the Grateful Red. I mean, they're just loving the fact that they're seeing shots go down. They're seeing it from some of their key players. Nigel Hayes has made some shots. Mito Brown hit a couple shots. And obviously, Bronson Kane's getting them to go. He's been fantastic here in the second half. He needs to continue to find this rhythm and keep that going, because if he does, this does all of a sudden look like a top 15 team.
So besides the free throw shooting, biggest thing Wisconsin needs to shore up before the NCAA tournament.
You have to shoot jump shots like you already know you're going to make it. That's what you've got to do. And I think the more you do that, the easier it is to make foul shots, because the less pressure there is on foul free throw shooting.
I'll flip it over to Minnesota. Now, this is rare. They're averaging 77 points a game. Wisconsin's defense has been good, but what about Minnesota?
Hey, let's go back to their struggles. That five-game skid, they really struggled on the offensive end. I mean, Penn State held them to 50 points. That was a 52-50 loss. So I do think a lot of it has to do with Jordan Murphy and his production, but you can't go through these lulls on the offensive end. Of course, credit Wisconsin. Wisconsin's terrific defensively.
Between this and the Iowa game, maybe as good back-to-back efforts defensively as Wisconsin's been all year. And how about offensively? Three straight three-pointers for Bronson Koenig. Rebound to Trice. They are standing at the Kohl Center with 90 seconds to go, as this has turned into an absolute dominating second half. Folks, Minnesota led by two at intermission.
It's been a tale of two halves, but it's also been Bronson Koenig. I mean, if he gets one to go here,
he's going to put it up, isn't he? No. Short. See, he was too close to the basket.
That's right. I mean, the last three, he got to go. There was no way that should have gone in.
Koenig going for the steal, and it forces Mason to kick it out of bounds.
The crazy thing about Bronson Koenig is he still hasn't shown a ton of emotion. I think I'm more emotional over here after seeing that one go. He shot an absolute moon ball.
Mom's happy.
Loves it.
What do you call that move, the tap of the head and the extension of the arms? That's just joy.
OMG.
After going 1 of 9 from downtown against Michigan State, two games this week, Koenig is 9 of 16 from long distance.
I love what Greg Gard's doing right now. He's going to give an opportunity to get these fans, let these fans give their seniors a standing ovation.
Eric Curry is fourth, the team's 10.
And this is going to be two shots for Bronson Koenig. Not a better way to go out, to play the way he has, to have the career that he's had here, to have all the success that this team's had. Now to knock down a couple foul shots and come out to a standing ovation. That's a special moment.
15 points, 5 of 8 from outside the arc. His first point, it's not a three-pointer right there.
Yeah, he better make this too, by the way. No pressure.
And now the substitution of the seniors is started.
Nigel Hayes bow.
The first two to go, Nigel Hayes and Zach Showalter. And joining them, Vito Brown and Bronson Koenig. And definitely our Duluth trading hardest working players. 110 wins, now 111 for that senior class.
They could have scored 0 points and made no field goals tonight. You still could have given it to them because of the type of careers that they've had. And this fan base really appreciates it.
Coffee strong inside. Rebound to Alex Ilikainen, and Wisconsin can dribble it out. That senior class, 4 away from the school record set by the 2015 crew. What a second half for the Badgers. They were down 29-27 at intermission. They turn the tables and win it 66-49. And in the process, they stop Minnesota's eight-game win streak. And they clinch the number two seed in the Big Ten tournament.
This is an incredibly important win for Wisconsin. But not just the win, but ultimately the way they did it, the way they were able to score from the perimeter in the second half. This should give them the confidence they need to go and actually make a run for a Big Ten title.
And Minnesota with the loss, they will be the four seed in the Big Ten tournament in Washington, D.C. Now, important to note that Minnesota will still get that coveted double bye. Both of these teams will. Maryland will be the three seed. Purdue, the outright Big Ten regular season champions, will take the number one seed in the Big Ten tournament. There's a look at the bracket. The 5 and 6 slots also locked in. Michigan State is the five seed. Northwestern with a loss earlier today to Purdue. They fall down to the number six seed. Everything starting Wednesday right here on BTN in our nation's capital. Nigel Hayes, Zach Showalter, Bronson Koenig, Vito Brown, the four seniors, got to go out to one final bow. And now they lock arms, as they always do here at the Kohl Center. And we go to Mr. John Crispin, who's with Greg Gard.
Coach, first and foremost, congratulations. It seemed as if the team had fun again. What was it about the second half?
Well, they've stuck together through this. It's been a rough couple weeks here. You know, obviously our league is extremely competitive, and we know we got a battle each time out. And teams go through rough spots. And, you know, I thought defensively we were really good in the second half, and obviously you get shots to go in, and great way to send out our four seniors.
What does it feel like as a coach where you're sitting at second in the conference, yet the feeling is this is as if you're at 14th? What does it feel like, and how do you keep your guys engaged?
I always try to focus just on our guys and not worry about what place we're in, just trying to do the best we can for our guys. And I just feel so happy for them right now, because I know how rough it's been and how personal they've taken it, because they've really made a huge commitment to our program. Obviously our seniors, Shoei's been here 5 years and the rest four, but everybody, all 17 guys have really committed, and they had each other's back when things weren't, you know, we were pretty lonely. There was a lot of, we were by ourselves in a lot of things, and they stuck together and kept working to get better.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Best of luck next week in
D.C. Thank you.
Greg Gard, his team just felt like so much relief in that second half after losing 5 of 6 to come out and just dominate the second 20 against a very good Minnesota team. Hayes, what a career he's had. He finished with 12 tonight. And let's go back to John. He's with Bronson Koenig, who had 17.
Bronson, 17 points. A little bit of foul trouble in the first half. Only played 5 minutes. Just tell me how good it felt to play in that second half.
It felt great. You know, I told myself at halftime I was going to, you know, let my confidence kind of drive me, and that's what I did the second half, and finally they started falling.
Now, you've been pretty stoic throughout this run, really throughout your career, so I'm not going to try to get you too emotional. But seeing your mother erupting over there, I mean, the experience you have has been absolutely terrific. Just talk a little bit about what it's been like to you.
Yeah, I mean, my family comes every game. Being only from 2.5 hours away, the support has been great for my family, to all the fans in the Kohl Center. So it's been a great 4 years.
All right, thanks a lot, Bronson. Hey, best of luck next week. I'm going to bring Nigel in. Nigel. Congratulations, first and foremost, on a great career here at Wisconsin. I want to give you just a second to talk about what your experience has been like. I mean, you've been Final Fours and Big Ten championships, and truthfully, you guys have set the bar so high for Wisconsin basketball. Just give me a sense of what it's been like.
Yeah, it's been great. You know, walking into this program, when I committed here, I had no idea I would do, you know, some of the incredible things I've been a part of. And that's just the beauty of it. And our expectations are so high. And, you know, even nowadays, our fans are a little upset with us. Like, you know, why are you guys losing? It's like, hey, you know, it wasn't always just beautiful, you know, before we got here. But we definitely appreciate the love and support they give us. And I'm just glad I could be a part of, you know, turning this program around to be mentioned with the higher-ups in the college program.
Yeah, in a way, you certainly brought this upon yourself, but you wouldn't have it any other way. How do you keep this going? Because there's been so many questions about whether you can score well enough to be a championship team. But today in the second half, you certainly looked like a championship team. How do you keep it going in the Big Ten tournament next week?
We just got to keep staying grounded to our principles, doing what we're doing. Today, in a month and a half, we finally played a good game of basketball, and you see the outcome. So when we play to our potential and do what we're supposed to do, we think we can play with and beat anybody. But it's up to us to take care of that.
All right, best of luck next week in D.C. We'll see you down there.
Nigel Hayes scoring over 1,750 points in his career, fourth all-time currently in a Wisconsin Badger uniform. They hold Minnesota to 32% from the field, just 23% in the second half, outscore them by 19 in the second frame, and win it 66-49. And the seniors get win number 111, and Minnesota's eight-game win streak is over. Stay tuned. Michigan and Nebraska coming up next. This has been an exclusive presentation of the Big Ten Network. For John Crispin, I'm Brandon Gaudin, saying so long from Madison.